The nature of the business week is that it's always changing, and that's why we come to you every Friday to dissect it and bring to you the latest information that will shape the economy. Hello and welcome to this week's Business Roundup. My name is Viola Kusasia, and some of the events that took place this week, we have the acting director of the National Payment Systems, the Bank of Uganda, saying that there is growth in fintechs, and by the end of 2022, there were 24 in number. How does that matter to you and I? We shall soon find out. Also, the Vision Group's Harvest Money Expo concluded on Sunday, but it left women entrepreneurs asking government for funding to be able to boost what they have started. Are they going to get this money? We are also going to find out. And also, electricity tariffs are soon going to be reducing, but in a phased manner, according to the Energy Minister, Honorable Ruth Nankabirwa. Now joining us is Paul Busharizi, a business journalist with the New Vision. So thank you, Paul, for making time to be with us today on this business roundup. Let's start off with the Bank of Uganda, where we see that there was growth in fintechs from the observation. So how do fintechs impact the economy here in Uganda, especially being that it's a new trend that is taking shape? How do you see this impacting us?
Fintechs, of course, as you know, have really done a lot to ease our lives. Created new business opportunities for hundreds of people. And they've done what banks have failed to do since independence or since they were set up in Uganda, is to increase the number of people with the accounts. So, you know, our mobile money accounts across all platforms are more than 10 million. And those are more than all the bank accounts in Uganda. And they've done this in less than 10, well, they've done it about 10 years. So it's a good thing.
The bank told us that these fintechs are regulated and we should not worry about anything. They are also credible. So do you see that this is actually what's on ground when you look at how many fintechs we've been using? We have mobile money, we have so many others. So do you see this being the truth, or is the bank a bit not aware of what's happening on the ground?
Well, I imagine all those things you might have suggested or you named are growing pains of the industry. It's a relatively new industry, and things have to be ironed out and stuff. But if you did as a percentage of all the transactions, I'm sure it's an insignificant number, less than 1% or even less than that. So I think the reliability is kind of straightforward. I think they're reliable enough, and I think they're getting more and more reliable with time.
It's very positive, you know, to register growth in any sector, but we've had several complaints, especially for me. Several Ugandans complain about what they order online versus what they get in reality. So do you see that there is a bit of a disconnect between the fintechs as they sound good, but also what happens with a regular Ugandan? So let's talk about that, and how can it be addressed, and also we stop the scamming of Ugandans, especially when they can't get what they requested for?
Well, I'm not sure about that, but the businesses that do not deliver what is required of them will flop, or they will be overtaken by more reliable people. You don't have to worry about it. So unfortunately, of course, if you're scammed or your order is misplaced or whatever, the pain is real for you at this time. But over the long period, the lousy guys will fall off or be overtaken. You don't have to worry about that.
All right, so Paul, the Vision Group's Harvest Money Expo just ended on Sunday, and last week was a beehive of activity. But the women entrepreneurs at that, you know, Vision Group Harvest Money Expo were excited to be there, but they left with a question. They need funding from the government, and I don't know what you think about it. Do you think this is a possible case for the government at this stage, especially having seen the budget that was announced just previously? Do you think this is possible for the government to hand out money to these women entrepreneurs?
I kind of feel sad when people, their first point of call when they're in trouble is the government. And I think then, so I feel sad for that. I think the government should be last resort, not first resort. That's where you go in your last resort. But also, the challenge for businesses generally, women or men in this country, is they're not organized enough. When you organize, the money comes for you. It actually literally follows you. So if you don't have money, it means you're not organized, as a basic principle in business and all that kind of business. So these ladies, if they could get organized, and when I talk about organized, I'm talking about things like come together as a group, save together. You know, as a group, you have bigger bargaining power. You can get things cheaper because you're buying in bulk. As a group, you can attract. You can have access to certain kinds of markets. It's a different market that will buy 10 tomatoes and another market that will buy 1,000. They're two different markets. But you see, maybe I can only produce 100 tomatoes on my farm. But if 10 of us women came together and we have 1,000, we move up to the next level.
And finally, let's talk about the business week ahead of us. What do you see that is likely to happen? And also, I would love a comment about the behavior of the shilling in the coming week.
So I think the shilling, we're coming towards the end of the month. NGOs and people like that, multinationals will be paying salaries, be changing dollars into shillings, so we can expect some support for the shilling in coming days until the end of the month and beyond. We're going to March. Some rain is supposed to come through in March, so we expect people to start planting. I think there's also a harvest season going on right now. We expect food prices to kind of stabilize over the next few weeks.
All right, Paul, thank you very much for making time to talk to us here on the Business Roundup. And thank you too for watching the Business Roundup. Every week we come to you with the latest happening in the world of business, and as a business person, you need this to be able to keep your feet on the ground. I am Violet Sasera. Back to the news.